I recently came back from a trip to the Netherlands last week Tuesday, so this vlog is a little bit late, but I did feel a bit tired and didn't have much energy for producing it. But I'm finally getting it done, so I hope you guys enjoy it. Started this day off with a double espresso, as I usually do, and ate quite a lot of food for breakfast. 250 grams of pasta with basil pesto and a carrot juice, which was at 1,500 calories. That's a big breakfast for me. And I needed it because it was going to be an epic ride. And you can see the fuel here loading up. 250 grams of sugar in the bottle. And 3 packs of pre-packaged food. These packs are about 300 calories each. And 750 grams of sugar so that I was bonk proof. And I'm adding quite a lot of shea butter to the chamois here, so that I don't have to add skin to the chamois, if you know what I mean. My fitness wasn't very good going into this bike trip. Because I've been training about 3 hours a week running, hardly spent any time on the bike, very little time on the bike this year, so I knew it was going to be quite an extreme challenge for me. Originally, I planned to do 600 kilometers and ride through the night, but the battery actually died of the Brighton towards the evening, so I decided to sleep on a bench. But I was actually quite close to a slaughterhouse for the cows, and the cows were making a lot of noise. So obviously I couldn't sleep with that going on, and it was highly disturbing. So I was actually lucky enough to stay with people for the night. They took me into their house. I was on the right driveway at the right time, and the woman was very kind. She said she'll let me sleep at their house for the night, and that was great. And you can see here that I met one of the cyclists on Col de la Schluch. This is about 5 or 6 kilometers outside of our town. Very nice older gentleman. Just had a good chat with him about his bike and cycling, you know, all the usual stuff. And yeah, I took a video of the nice little town. I really like the texture of the road, so I think that's what encouraged me to take a little video of this scenery over here. So on day one, Col de la Schluch was the only real climb of the day. It is 14.5 kilometers at 5%, and it was at the beginning. So it's not like one of those stages where you have the big climb at the end of the day when you're really fatigued, and the last thing you want to think about is climbing up a hill. So that was pretty cool about the route. And you can see the scenery is magnificent. Lots of trees, lots of nature. This is still in France over here. And it was going to be about 240 kilometers before crossing over into Luxembourg. And that's a cool thing that I noticed about crossing over into each new country, is the roads are different and the buildings are different, and even the bike paths are different. Almost 90 kilometers done and entering into another little town here in France. The last time I went to Holland was back in 2010. And yeah, that was when I was still riding for the national team, or racing for the national team. And yeah, we were racing quite a lot. You could race 5 times a week if you wanted to, but yeah, I did a race probably twice a week on average. And even that was pretty hard. The races are quite interesting over there. They do these criteriums of 100 kilometers, and you probably do 100 laps because the laps are so short. You do 1 kilometer laps. I remember before one of those races eating 300 grams of chocolate and having 15 cups of coffee. I was buzzing off my freaking rocks, my brew. But yeah, overall, Holland was probably the best experience that I had while I was in Europe. Stayed there for about 1 month or even 5 weeks, I think. And yeah, I went to multiple countries in Europe racing. Portugal, Spain, Italy, France, Belgium. And also Germany, yes. And overall, Holland was the best. I really like it because they can speak English there. Or rather, Holland is the most English-speaking European country that I'm aware of. Yeah, you can see I just took a little bench break, stopped for one of these meals. And this was about 142 kilometers into the trip. Lots of bike paths on the trip too. That's what I really liked about it. And that's a cool feature about having the premium version of Strava, is you can create any bike route that you want. You can maximize the elevation, minimize the elevation, or just keep the standard elevation. And it also takes you on the most popular routes. And yeah, I stopped again because I was getting some sugar water fatigue. So I decided to opt for a baguette instead. And you can see the 3 bottles of water there. Ice cold, love it. That stop was after 220 kilometers. And here you can see the footage of Luxembourg. This was probably after about 250 kilometers. Also some nice scenery over here. And I enjoyed the little suburb / neighborhoods they had. That was a really pleasant environment to ride through.
This next song is about the heavy metals that people are getting up in planes every fucking day and spraying on our heads, spraying into our water supplies, spraying into the soil. This is a program of eugenics. And they want to call it some scientific bullshit like stratospheric aerosol geoengineering or solar radiation management. You know what I call it? I call it that we're being sprayed like bugs.
Yeah, I just had to put that little truth nugget in there. Really irks me to see the skies being sprayed on the entire 600 kilometer trip to Holland. There wasn't a single patch of sky that wasn't being sprayed with that chemtrail shit. So this was just before I was about to crash, probably about an hour, and was the last footage that I filmed on day one. And it was starting to get dark, but still not too dark. This is about 9:30 in the evening. Sun sets at about 10:30 now in Europe, or at least the part of Europe that I'm in. And you can see the environment is absolutely breathtaking. I just love how pleasant it is. So this is the home of the generous couple that took me in, and I slept here on the floor. It was really comfortable. First I started out on the couch, but the floor was better. And I didn't film the actual breakfast of the next day, but I had muesli with sugar and water and a cup of coffee. And here we have footage of day two. A wonderful day again, and still some footage of the bike paths here in Luxembourg. And that's what I like about Luxembourg too, is also wonderful bike path infrastructure. It's a small country, so I guess it's not as difficult to manage as a larger country like France. But yeah, got to give them credit for the great infrastructure that they've built over here, and how the bike paths are separate from the road, which makes it a lot better. When it comes to calories, I was averaging about 5,000 to 6,000 per day for a 300 kilometer ride. So probably a little bit of a deficit, as I couldn't really manage to eat that much food, but I definitely made up for it in the following days after the rides. And this was the last footage that I had of Luxembourg. And you can see I'm going really slowly here because I'm doing about a 7% gradient climb. I think it climbed for about 400 meters or so. I definitely noticed the extra 5 kilos on the bike. It made it harder to climb, as well as getting out of the saddle and the bike sways to and fro in a pendulum motion. You feel that extra weight for sure. But yeah, after like 200 kilometers, you get so used to it that you don't even notice it's there anymore. And crossing over into Belgium now, you can see that the paths are definitely different. Even had a gravel stretch here, as you can see. What I really liked about Belgium is they had these rest stop spots on the side of the bike paths where you could go under the roof and get some shelter from the rain if you wanted to. You could sit and eat your food, and you could even get some rest for your back, as you can see with these chairs over here. Wow, this is awesome. So this is still Belgium, and I saw a guy with a trike on the road, so I thought, why the fuck not, let's film it, looks interesting. And the road crossings are marked with green paint and these little gates so that the cars don't go on the bicycle path. On day two, the most difficult thing physically to deal with wasn't even leg fatigue. My legs were fine, I could manage to ride probably another 600 kilometers if I really wanted to. But it was definitely the back pain that was the hardest thing physically. Had to stretch quite often, and even had to stop and lie down on the benches just for the back to recover a bit. And yeah, that was because I just wasn't used to riding a lot, and also the aggressive bike position that I have. First footage of Deutschland was stopping for some Pringles, water, and Wi-Fi. And you can see it was different from the other countries because of this wide paved road out in the open fields. And I also noticed that there was slightly less bike path infrastructure, so I was spending more time on the actual main road. But that was cool too because it increased the average speed. And talking about average speed, you'll see now in the Strava summaries that my average speed wasn't actually that quick. It was just between 26 and 27 kilometers per hour. Usually for rides this long with this kind of elevation, if I'm in good shape, I can easily cruise at around 30 kilometers per hour. So yeah, it just goes to show that just 3 hours of running per week isn't gonna amount to incredible fucking endurance fitness. And finally, I just couldn't resist to film the ferry crossing in Holland. That was really cool for me. I've actually never been on a ferry like this before. All the cars and the bikes just park on it and then it goes across. You pay €1 to get across. I also love how nice a lot of these bike paths are in Holland with their maroon color and separated from the sidewalk. That really makes the infrastructure a lot better than usual. And here are the statistics for each day in order from day 1 to day 4. I rode 2 days to get to Holland and 2 days back. Stayed there for 9 days, so I had a good little recovery period before the next 600 kilometer trip. I'll leave a link to all of the rides in the description below, and here are some photos of my time in Holland. Enjoy.